Hello everybody, this is Scott Bradley from the website scottbradley.name, and in this video I'm going to share with you the 10 features that make Evernote massively powerful as a tool to use in your daily life, either as an entrepreneur or as a busy professional. If you haven't already created your account, I recommend that you do so. All you have to do is go to evernote.com, and in the top right hand corner, go through the prompts to create your account with your username and whatnot. I'm going to show you, this is the web-based version of the application, but as you know, there's also a Mac-based version of the application, and I will be showing you a couple of the features that you're able to have in the web application compared to the web app application. So I'm going to start with the web app features, and then I'm going to move right into the application features, and I do believe that they do have it for PC as well as Mac. So within Evernote, when you get your account, the inside of Evernote is going to look like this. You're going to have a left-hand panel that's going to show notebooks and tags. You're going to have this column here, which will basically show the notes within each notebook. And then over here is basically where the note content is. So if you're new to Evernote, you're going to know that you're going to find out that the way the content and the organization of the actual application is, you have your notebooks at the top, your notes within the notebook, be able to select, and then content within each notebook. So I know that may be a little confusing, but I'm going to make it clear for you by going through each of the features. So within Evernote, again, when you sign in, this is what it looks like. And so the very first feature that I want to show you is that you can create a series of notebooks, an unlimited amount of notebooks within Evernote. And I'm going to show you why that's valuable. So in here, to create a notebook, you're going to come here, you're going to click this downward arrow and click New Notebook. And we're just going to call it Test. And then the best thing about creating notebooks is that you can create notes within notebooks. So as you can see here in the top right hand corner, you have a new note, and we're just going to title, do a test and a test as the note content. And you're going to click Done. Now, as you can see here, within the note test notebook, there was a new test that was created, and then you have the word test within the note content. And the best thing about this is you can go in here and actually add more text. And click Done, and you have your notes. So imagine in each notebook you can have an unlimited amount of notes that are in this notebook in and of itself. So that moves me to my next feature that I'm going to show, feature number two, which basically I'm going to show you that you can quote what's called stacking notebooks. So for instance, say you have a series of notebooks that you want to group under one specific category, you can do that in Evernote very, very easily. So the way to do that, again, I'm going to just create a brand new notebook. Test 2. So as you can see here, I have Test and Test 2 notebooks. And what I want to do is say, for instance, both of these notebooks were different types of food, and I wanted to create like a super notebook and call that Food Notes. And this one would probably be Japanese, and this one would be Chinese. So, and I'm just using that as an example. You can use it the way you want, but I'm just showing you how to work it. So what you do is to create a stack, you click the notebook, and then you drag it on top of Test 2, and then you let go of your mouse. And you're going to name the stack. We're going to do Food Types. Save. So as you can see here, it created a super notebook and sub notebooks under that super notebook. And the thing is, you can make it go big, make it go small, all that good stuff. And it's just a really, really great feature that makes Evernote so awesome, because you can really organize lots of information. And in all the videos that I create here on the YouTube channel, you will see that this is really valuable. So stacks are the second thing. The third thing that I want to show you, and again, we're going to go back to that one place with the note. I'm going to refresh here. All right, so the next feature that I want to show you is what are called tags. So depending on how your brain works, my brain works differently than yours, obviously, but the next thing I want to show you is what are tags and why they're valuable. So thinking of the framework, you have your notebook, you have your note within the notebook, and you have the content of the note within the notebook. And what's great is that the tags allow you to create one more type of filtering mechanism within your Evernote notebook to be effective in finding what you need or using information in a strategic way to accomplish goals and results and all that stuff. So I'm going to show you how to do that within the web notebook, or within the web-based application. So all you have to do is come up here and click Edit. And as you can see here, there's Alt Add Tags. So what you do is you click on that, and we're just going to do Test Tag. And once you're done with that, click Off, press Done. And as you can see here, there's a tag called Test Tag. Now, I'm going to refresh for you to show you why that's valuable. If you notice, in the left-hand column, you know we have all of our notebooks up here, and in the bottom left-hand corner, we have our tags. So say, for instance, you have hundreds of thousands of notes in here, and they're all tagged appropriately and whatnot. If you click up here in All Notes, which basically, again, shows you all of the notes that you have, and you know this Welcome to Evernote note is what shows up immediately when you first sign in. And actually, instead of 10 features, I'm going to show you 11 features. I just now realized that I forgot one, so I'm going to explain what the Web Clipper is at the very end. Let me write that down here. Okay. So, best thing about tags is that if you select the All Notebook notebook and you press Test Tag, it will only pull up the notes that are tagged with that actual tag that you created. So, you know, again, if you can imagine, depending on how your brain works, depending on what type of information and certain things that you're integrating into your life when using this application, you'll be able to use tags effectively. And again, in all these videos that I'm creating for you, I will show you certain ways to leverage tags as you integrate Evernote into your life to be more effective as an entrepreneur or a busy professional. All right. Next thing I want to show you is that makes Evernote so awesome, as I'm a massive proponent of Evernote, is the search feature. And again, this is another filtering mechanism to help you find information that you need in a quick, efficient way. So I'm just going to show you how it works. So typically when I do searches within my Evernote, what I make sure I first do is click All Notes at the top. And then as you see here, there's a search bar. And I, for instance, say we want to find the note, you know, that says test in it. All that you have to do is go test, search, boom, there it is. So it pulls up notes within notebooks with the words that you're searching for. And again, from a filtering mechanism, from a, oh, I know I wrote that down in Evernote, but I just don't know where it is, the search feature really helps you be effective in finding those in that type of information when you need it most. So that's really good. The next feature that I'm going to show you, which is feature number, one, two, three, four, five on our list, is the ability to share notes with people via a link. Whether you want to share it in Facebook, share it in Twitter, share it in email, this is a really, really great feature that, you know, depending on how you use it or depending on if you want to use it, you know, you do have this option. So I'm just going to show you how to do that real quick. So I'm going to go back down to our test one notebook with this actual note, and I'm going to show you how to do it. It's really, really simple. In the top right-hand corner, you're going to see the share button with a downward arrow. And then there's this menu that pops up. What you're going to do is you're going to click Link, and it's going to give you this link in this note URL. So I'm going to do Command C in my Apple, or if you're on a PC, you want to do Control C to copy it. You're going to close, and as you can see here, this is now shared. And so if I open up a new window and I press, you know, Control V, which copies it, this is an actual public-based note that I can share via email. If I want to throw it into Facebook or I want to throw it into Twitter, you know, you do have that option, which is a really, really great feature, really, really great, you know, feature within Evernote that allows you to use it in a myriad of ways depending on what your needs are as a busy professional or an entrepreneur. So I really like this feature. Now, if you wanted to turn the sharing off of a specific note, all that you need to do is come up here, press Shared, and press Stop Sharing. Stop sharing. Boom. And you're done. So you can turn it on, you can turn it off, depending on what you need to do. It's really effective. So I'm sure your brain is swirling with ideas right now, but I'm just going to keep going. So the next feature on our list, as you can share notes, you can also share notebooks, which is another great feature within Evernote if you're doing projects with teams that are, you know, remote, whether your friend is in New York and you have another friend in Indiana or another friend in Texas and you're in California. You can share notebooks and create an entire project and manage a lot of stuff within one notebook within Evernote, which again, it's a really valuable thing. So I'm going to show you how to do that. And again, very similarly to sharing individual notes, you're going to do it the same exact thing. So just again, make sure that the notebook that you want to share is highlighted. And in the top right-hand corner, you're going to see the share button and it says share notebooks. So, you know, you share the notebook and then you basically select which one you want to start sharing, and then it's going to ask you what are the emails of the people that you want to share this with, and then it will send them the invites via email, and then they can follow the process of accepting the shared notebook. Very, very cool feature if you are managing virtual teams or your team's virtual, whatever it is that you do, it's really effective. So I really like that feature as well. Now, another feature that makes Evernote so awesome is that, you know, as you all know, we all have an email account. We all have an email client that we're using, whether it's Gmail or Macmail or Outlook or, you know, Hotmail or whatever. One great awesome thing about Evernote is that you can actually send stuff into Evernote via an email address. And when you sign up for your Evernote account, you're going to sign in with two notebooks already created. You're going to have an All Notes, which is standard. You can't delete this notebook. And you're also going to have another notebook with a little star next to it. Now, I've renamed this notebook Inbox. I don't exactly remember what it's titled, but the fact that it has the star, that becomes your what's called your default notebook, which basically means anything that you send into Evernote is going to land within this notebook, which again, it's just the way Evernote works. And I'm going to show you how to find that email address and so you can start sending good stuff into your Evernote inbox. So the way to do that, it's really simple. You come up into the top right hand corner and you see your username. What you want to do is click that username and you're going to see settings. So you want to click settings. And as you can see here, it says email notes 2, and it gives you this email with this really strange, weird email address. So basically the way that works is I'm going to go to my email account here real quick. And, you know, if I have a note that I want to send in, or I get an email from somebody that I want to send into my Evernote, all that I do is I put up the message or I press the forward button, like that, boom, and that's my Evernote email. So anything that I get that I want to save but I don't necessarily want to delete from my Evernote inbox, I can forward it on into the Evernote account, which again, if you can imagine the organization that you can create within that for stuff that you want to save but you don't want to keep in your inbox because you want to keep your inbox clean. You know, there's various uses for this, and it's really, really effective for organizing and staying on top of your life to get more done in less time and just be more productive and have greater peace of mind, which is really my reason for using Evernote within my life, along with a couple other systems that I've set up for myself, and I may get into those in later videos depending on how this content is received by you guys. So again, email into Evernote is the feature that I just went over. And for the most part, the last feature that you can integrate into Evernote in the web-based version is the Web Clipper. Now, you know, what the Web Clipper is it's a plugin that you can put into your browser that allows you to save any types of pages that you come across online. So I'm sure that this is in Chrome. And I'm sure that once you install the Web Clipper, I personally don't use it myself. If I need something, I'll take a screenshot of it and throw it into Evernote as an attachment. But, you know, if you want to save web-based stuff, what you want to do is download the Web Clipper. And I'm sure, based on the way Chrome is set up, it would probably show up in the top right-hand corner, and it will probably look like the elephant logo of the Evernote thing. So say you go to a website, you like what you see, you press the Evernote Web Clipper, you title the note, you may tag the note if you want to, put a little bit more content, and you press, you know, send into my Evernote. And more likely than not, it will come into your default notebook, which then once it's there, then you can figure out how you want to process it from that point, which is really, really great. So with all that being said, this is the web-based version of the different features that make Evernote really popular. And what I really love to use it for. But now what I'm going to show you is when you decide to download the application either for Mac or PC, I'm going to show you a couple more features that make Evernote really powerful. So I highly recommend if you aren't able to, if you are able to download the application on your computer, because you get more functionality and more features that I'm going to go over. There's three features that make it even better, in my opinion. So again, I've created this blank notebook, and here's my Evernote, and I'm going to go into all of these other notebooks and how I use them more in detail in other videos. But for the sake of the example, I want to show you the other valuable things that can be done within the actual application when you download it. So there's three specific things. The very first thing is that, you know, when you edit notes, you can, you know, add text, you can click off, and then you click it in and you can add text again. Now that, I don't know if that's really a feature, but you know, you don't always have to be pressing edit, done, and I don't know, it's just a convenience thing in and of itself. But the first thing that I want to show you for the first feature is that you can add in audio clips, which is awesome. So if you can see here at the top of this bar, which is like the editing bar, you are able to have this little microphone and it says record audio. So if I wanted to record a short little audio clip, like I get an idea or something that I just want to throw in and put down, all I have to do is press this little audio thing, press the record button, and as you can see, it's recording my voice as I'm talking. You press record, and we're just going to test it here. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, save it, boom, and then there is that audio for you to use. And as you can see here, it shows that there is an audio note within this. It's awesome. So that's, you know, the first feature that I wanted to show you within the actual application. And the second feature is that if you have, say you go to a networking event and you get a slew of business cards and you come home, you pull out the ones that you want, you throw away the ones that you don't, but you don't want to just like pull the ones that you want and throw them on the desk. You want to actually have them someplace that's measurable, not measurable. You can find them easily. So another great thing is that if you look up here, there's something that kind of looks like the Picasa logo from Google for their picture application, their web-based picture platform. So basically this, it says take a snapshot. So for instance, say you have those business cards and you want to put them in Evernote and you want them to be searchable and whatnot, you can click take snapshot, you know, and I have an Apple, so I have a computer right in the top of my screen, so I can take a snapshot of that business card, and once that picture is in there, then it even recognizes the text. So say for instance you knew that you met a John who was a graphic designer at a event, and you wanted to pull his information up and give him a call because you needed his services. You can go in again, you know, click your all notebooks, and then the search bar for me is up here. I can press the word John, and all the notes with the word John in it, as well as the pictures with the text John on it, will be pulled up. So you can do that for pictures, you can do that for information, you could do that for, you know, whatever it is that works for you, you can use it for that, which is really, really valuable. Now the final feature that I want to show you is that you can actually also add attachments into Evernote within each note. So as you can see here, there's a little paperclip, which is attach a file. And the best thing is you can actually either click and drag and drop into these notes to drop your stuff, or you can use this Evernote Web Clipper. So if you have lots of different files for different clients that you're dealing with, or you just like to save pictures and you want to create a notebook of pictures within your Evernote as a notebook, so you know, again, kind of the structure, you have a pictures notebook, and then within each note you have a picture, and then within each note you have a content. You can also click, drag, drop, whatever. For me, as a copywriter, as a marketer, as an entrepreneur, I like to do, you know, take pictures of ad copy or ad creative and click and drag and drop and put in my swipe file. And I'm going to show you in one of the later videos within this channel how I do that really effectively. So this concludes the video of all of the great, amazing features that makes Evernote completely incredibly awesome for entrepreneurs, busy professionals, and people that just love being organized and love being on top of the ball. And again, in the other videos, I'm going to go through some more amazing stuff, so be sure to check out my channel. Again, this is Scott Bradley from scottbradley.name, and I hope that you got a lot of value out of this, and I look forward to hearing your feedback. So please do leave your comments below. All right, have a great rest of your day, and I'll talk to you soon.